In the series of visualization videos so far, we have covered the ideas of big picturing and a surface patchwork approach. Today, we will take a look at a multi-body approach. Here we have quite an interesting design for a tank or a vessel. Thank you to Josh for sending this design to me. When trying to reverse engineer a model, the first step is always to pose the question, can we start with a basic overall shape and cut it down to this final shape? In this case, the answer is quite clearly no. Next, let's consider the surface patchwork approach. Can we build this by building a patchwork of surfaces? Let's try to identify the main faces. There are three types of faces here. We have a cylindrical face here. Straddling across the cylindrical face are three conical faces. And lastly, we have lofted faces capping both ends. We can definitely build surfaces and trim the excess. But in this case, the trimming can be quite complicated. It would actually be easier to apply a multi-body approach. Basically, we will be creating separate solid bodies in the form of a cylinder and a cone and applying Boolean operations between them. Lastly, we will cap both ends with solid lofts. Before we start, let's identify planes of symmetry. There is a plane of symmetry along the right plane. At the same time, recognize also that there are three identical segments. We shall build the center segment, create a copy on one side, make the loft, and finally mirror everything across the right plane. There is also a plane of symmetry along the front plane. However, making use of that would actually complicate the workflow, as that will require us to build half a cylinder and half a cone, so we will not be using that. Start with a sketch on the right plane. Create a circle. And extrude into a cylinder symmetrically. Next, we are going to create a profile for revolving the cone. Start a sketch on the front plane. This will be a right angle triangle with its corner at the origin. Go to Create, Revolve. Select the profile and the axis. For operation, set to New Body. We have two separate bodies overlapping each other. Comparing to the final model, we can see a hint of how the cylindrical face can join to the conical face. From here, we need to make use of Boolean operations to allow these two bodies to interact with each other. By far the most powerful Boolean command we have is the boundary fill command. However, this can be tricky to use as cell selection is not exactly user-friendly. Go to Create, Boundary Fill. Select the cylinder and the cone as tools. The boundary fill command computes the interacting volumes between the two bodies and offers up cells for selection. To help in our selection, let's change the environment to dark sky. This will allow us to more easily see the cells being highlighted. Click on the select box and start selecting the required cells. For operation, set to New Body. We shall check the Remove Tools option. This will remove all the remaining unused volumes from this interaction. Let's check the browser. In one fell swoop, the command has joined the required volumes and removed the excess. An alternative to the boundary fill command is the split body command, which I will be explaining here. It is more tedious and requires a good understanding of how the command works. The geometry involved can be quite tricky to visualize. If you are not interested in this method, feel free to use the timestamps to skip to the next chapter. Let's roll back to the point where we had the cylinder and the cone as separate bodies. First, let's try to remove the excess cylindrical volume that is on top of the cone. We can use the cone as a cutting tool in this case. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the cylinder as a body to split. For splitting tool, click on the Select box. When it comes to tool selection, we can select either a face or the whole body. In this case, we need to select the conical face. If we select the whole body, the flat base of the cone would also be employed as a cutting tool, which we do not want. If we hover over the conical face, notice that it turns a slightly paler shade. If we hover over an edge, the whole body gets highlighted. So make sure you hover over the surface before you click. Be sure to uncheck the Extend Splitting Tool option to prevent this error. Once you confirm, you can see that a new body has been formed. This is the portion of the body that has been split out from the cylinder. Let's right-click and remove this body. Let's compare this to the final model. We need to remove this portion of the cone that is outside the boundaries of the cylinder. This time, we are going to flip the rolls around. The cylinder will serve as a cutting tool. Start the split body command again. Select the cone as a body to split. For a splitting tool, click on the Select box. Selecting this face will not be sufficient in cutting out the required portion. We need to select the whole body. Hover the cursor over an edge of the cylinder, and notice how the whole body gets highlighted. Click at this point to select the body. Looking at the browser, you can see that two new bodies have been created from the splitting of the cone. We shall remove the unwanted body. Go to Modify, Combine, and combine all the bodies into one single solid. Create a sketch on the front plane. Use this sketch line to split out the tip of the cone. We shall create a copy of the body on the left side. This can be done with the pattern command or the move copy command. Let's use the pattern command. Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. For type, select bodies and select the existing body. For direction, select the x-axis. Adjust the quantity and spacing. For the lofted end, we shall use this face as the starting profile. For the ending profile, let's create an offset plane. Start a sketch on this plane. And draw a circle tangent to the existing cylinder. Go to Create, Loft. Select the starting and end profiles. For the tangency options, set both as connected. Combine both these bodies. Mirror the body across the right plane. As long as you set the operation to join, any overlapping region will be merged into the final body.